The New York Institute for the Blind. I went to school for a while in Vermont. I lived in Vermont for a while. White River Junction.
That's where my family goes. The property up
there. Then, after leaving the New York Institute for the Blind, because what happened was, during that time, they didn't have contact lenses, they didn't have glasses for me. So I was considered legally blind because I can only see 3 feet in front of me. And today, if I take my lens out, I still can only see 3 feet in front of me. With them on, 20/20 vision. That's amazing. But I did a lot of crazy things, man. Not crazy, but it was interesting. Because I also went in the service. And you would say, well, how are you getting the service and you can't see? It's funny saying, I went down with 15 guys from Rudner Court, because I'm originally from New York.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Out of the 15 guys, only 2 guys passed the written test, me and another guy. I had already taken the Navy test. I failed it because of my eyes. I took the Air Force test. I failed it because of my eyes. Okay, the guy going to keep these 2 guys. So he says, all right, strip down everything but your drawers. Well, the other guy that passed with me, he didn't have no drawers on. The guy's moving like this. Didn't I tell you to keep your drawers on? Oh, I don't wear none in the summer. We get in the room. The guy looks at me with my big, thick glasses. He says, all right, take your glasses off. Read the chart. I says, okay. E. He said, next. He said, next, because he wasn't about. He had 15 men he took down and only 2 passed. So next thing I know, I'm in a room with my hands raised. I didn't think nothing of it. Went home, forgot all about it, getting ready to go back to school. All of a sudden, I get a letter, welcome. Report that. Oh, man. But, you know, it was exciting because you would think that they wouldn't have accepted me. Not until my last year, 1 month before my last year, I broke my glasses. Now I can't see. So they send me to the eye doctor to get new glasses. He looks at me, how in the hell did you get in this man's army? So when I told him, next thing I know, I'm sitting in a place, a round table, a bunch of officers. So I told him the story. That's how I got out.